So we've got a couple of busy hours now in the electrical workshop. I've caught somebody here on their phone, so let's grill them. Lewis, what's going on? You're on your phone?
Yeah, just on my emails.
And why would you be looking at your emails in my lesson?
Just been offered a job.
Offered a job, what, at McDonald's?
No, Apprenticeship.
At what's... Electrical. Oh, who with?
Yeah, after electrical.
Well done, mate, congratulations. Fantastic. Tell your face you're happy.
Yeah, happy this time.
Let's go over and have a word with Frederick, see what Frederick's up with. Okay, Freddy, what are you up to today?
Trunking lid.
And what are you practicing for? What assessment are you practicing for?
4357
entry assessment. Okay, so as we look down here, we've got a trunking exercise of which you're putting the lid on. Did you have to make the flat 90 in there, or did you use a pre-manufactured one?
Yeah.
Do you have to make it for your assessment?
Yes, we do.
Okay, and what are you doing now, did you say?
Just filing off the edge of this to make it smooth, and then hopefully it'll fit in.
Hopefully. Better get a word with Taylor, because Taylor doesn't come very often. But when you do come, Taylor, what do you always bring in for me?
Sweets
and?
Drink.
You do, yes. So we allow you to be a little bit more sporadic with your attendance because you offer the chocolate and fizzy beverages for gals, don't you? Here's one of the nicest guys you're ever likely to meet. Shy Joe, how are you doing, Joe?
Yeah, I'm good, thank you.
And you on the lid as well?
Yeah, just filing off the edges.
Okay. And if you don't turn up very often, you're still wiring the exercise, I see, as we're here with a fizzy beverage in face, yeah? Let's go around here. We got over it. Oh, is that another phone? I can see a phone. Nope, it's a screwdriver. Reith, how's it going?
Yeah, it's going good.
Oh, that's pretty good. So you're wiring up.
Currently, I'm just getting ready to put the second light fitting in, because the way we're doing it is we've got to do like one way.
Yep.
And then one way, and then we're merging it to make two way.
Okay. Okay.
So different variants of the steel
conduit. Okay, and this is a EAL level 2 practical assessment, yes?
Yes, indeed.
So you made the crank set?
Yeah, I made every bit of steel conduit on the wall.
Wow, that's really good. That's quite a complicated exercise. Are you currently employed?
No, I'm not.
So you did all of that just by coming to college on a full-time course?
Indeed, I did.
Well done, Reith. Oh, so we got, let's go and have a word with Tom. Thomas, how's it going?
Good, yeah.
Thomas is the learner that I keep quoting as being the best level one learner I've had, certainly in the last 5 years. And how many more of the assessments have you got left to finish in order to complete your level one?
No, this is my last one.
And which month of the year are we in?
We're in March.
And when does your course end?
June.
Okay, so we're slightly ahead of programme. Do you agree? Okay, that's brilliant. Your work is fantastic and you thoroughly deserve an apprentice opportunity. Not only is your practical work fantastic, but your academic side also, Tom, I'd like to thank you for, is brilliant as well. Here we go. Here's the bloke with the coolest surname. What's your surname?
Fett.
What's your brother's name?
Fett.
Boba. So it's cool. And what are we working on?
Steel trunking.
Steel trunking, yeah. And is this a level one practical exercise?
It's not level one.
We've been sneaky, haven't we? We've changed the level one job to make it look like the level two ready for next year. That is really good practice. You're doing great work. Keep it up. Stoyan, the man with the most luscious beard coming along here. How are we doing, Stoys?
I'm all right, I suppose.
Yeah, good. What are you working on at the moment?
The cable tray SY.
Okay, SY flex job, yeah? Okay, brilliant. Okay, and we've got the coolest t-shirt in the world. So let's have this cool t-shirt. Look at that. What was the reason you got let onto the course then, Luke? You wore a Star Wars t-shirt. Were you a very good academic attender at school?
No.
No? Were you a bit of a flake at school?
Yeah.
You were. And how did you get on the course again?
Wearing a Star Wars t-shirt.
And you said to me, Joe, you're wearing a return of... No, you're wearing a...
I think it was a New Hope.
It was a New Hope t-shirt. So any piece of advice for anyone? Star Wars is the way forward. Well done, Luke. Here we go, my email friend. We can't say your email address on camera. How are we doing? How many times do I mention your email address?
So many times.
So many times?
Yeah,
is it because your email address was inappropriate?
Yeah.
Was it inappropriate? Yes. Who else can we find? Who else can we go on to? Look, no, not allowed to wear hats in college, but of course, because I'm leaving in 2 weeks, I've let that one fly. How are we doing?
Good, thanks. How are you?
What's your boss's name?
Ricky,
yeah. And how do I know your boss? I taught him as well, didn't I? And when you drop the ball a little bit with your attendance, or you're a little bit full of yourself, what happens to you?
I get told off at work.
Why is that?
Because, you know, Ricky.
I tend to ring him, don't I? I tend to give Ricky a ring or a little text and just keep him up to date. It's good fun though, isn't it? Ricky's a lovely bloke as well. So we're all busy working away in the workshop, all on different jobs, so there's a lot of differentiation going on. People being stretched within their exercise. You know, we saw one lad today who's already got an apprenticeship. Okay, I'm sure people will be saying, oh, they should all be wearing X, Y, and Z. Currently, the PPE that people are wearing, I haven't picked up on because there is no issues as far as our risk assessments are within the workshop. So just popped over here to Finn. Hello, Finn. How are we doing?
You all right? Yeah, good.
Have you got any news for the camera?
Yeah, I've got an apprenticeship.
Electrical apprenticeship?
Yeah.
All right. And when do you start that apprenticeship, do you think?
3 weeks' time.
3 weeks' time. So another person has got an apprenticeship. You only got that, what was it, last week or the week before you got that?
Last week. Yeah,
fantastic. Congratulations, Finn.
Cheers.
Well done, mate. Get on with your job now, all right? We might catch up with Lewis over there in a minute. Frantically squaring off an end of conduit that he doesn't need to square off yet because he's going to have to cut it again. So he's wasting time. With it. I won't go over just yet and remind him that he doesn't need to do it. I'll let him do a little bit more filing first, I think. Let's see if we can find anyone else who's got some exciting news. This man here, I think, has got some exciting news. Emilio, have you got any exciting news for me?
Yeah, I'm starting at Tresham College.
As a full-time lecturer?
Full-time.
Yeah, you've come on as...
I'm excited about it.
Yeah, good man. And you came on as agency, and now you're going to be a full-time member of staff. Probably going to employ you after the coronavirus, aren't they? So they don't have to pay you during the off-time. That's really good. Exciting news. Good lad. There's a video coming out with Emilio in. There may be more than one, depending on if I can get to him in time. Let's go and see what Lewis is up to. Lewis is currently bending his steel conduit. I think you're putting a crank set in, yes?
Yeah.
Okay, then get it ready. Okay, and we'll be back to you in a minute. Oh, young man, young man. You're busy helping people. What are you helping people for me today? And which level are you working at?
Level 2.
You are, yeah, so you're doing really well. So you're currently the stand-in teacher because your teacher's got a camera in his hand and he's walking around, obviously interviewing people, so you're currently the teacher. Do you want a shout out? You need a job, don't you? Yeah, it'd be nice to have a job. Do you think you deserve a job?
Yeah.
I think you deserve a job as well. So yeah, it would be nice if we could have people pitching in that they would like to give you a job. Right, Lewis, you ready? Okay, so. Hello, Alex. Of all the jobs you're doing at the minute, which number are you on? Number 1, number 2, number 3, number 4, number 5, number 6, number 7, or number 8?
Number 8.
And that means you're almost finished your, which level are you at?
Level 1.
And if I was giving out the most improved award since Christmas, who would win it?
Me.
You would win it, yes, Alex. You're knocking the ball out of the park now. Where's Lewis? Is he is anywhere near? He's got the... it's going to be a disaster over there when this crank set, but we're going to record it anyhow. He's a good lad, Lewis. He deserves a job as well. Fantastic work experience at the minute, but he needs to turn it into an apprenticeship. Both of those guys could do with a job. Did I say to wear gloves when filing? Okay, no pressure now then, Lewis. So Spence is watching. He's beady eye on him. He's got his beady eye on him. Okay then, so we're going to try and do the bubble set on camera. Student, pull it. Oh, no, really? It's already... Remember, you are slightly strong, so is that 100 mil? I don't think so. Keep going, keep going, keep going. Keep going, keep going, keep going. Go on, a bit more. Way too much. Take it over to the bench then. Let's see what we're at. So we're going to take this over. Gas light system between... It's nowhere near. Between 100 and 110, but not 110. So we're going to put it on the edge of the bench. So bring it down to the edge. Keep going down to the edge. Down to the edge, that's it. Good lad. So down to the edge. And what's that, about 50?
Seven.
So, okay, so what does it need to be?
100.
So let's go back in. Let's bend a bit more. No pressure. He's wearing his best tracksuit today. He came in the other week all in red. I thought Father Christmas had turned up. I wonder if I could cut to a photograph now of you looking like Father Christmas. We don't want to mention Christmas jumpers though, because you knew you fell out with me in year one, didn't you? Everybody came to me and said he's properly angry with you, Gaz. Your mum had a lovely Facebook picture, didn't she, of your one of your Christmas adventures. Cut to that picture. So there we go. So we're trying to get that down to 100. I bet we're nowhere near still, are we?
Or
we
are?
A little bit more. So we're going to go a little bit more. Okay. How's he doing, Spence? Yeah, it's all right. You've got to work on your mumbling. Yeah? There he goes again. So. It's go and get the glory there, Spence, at the end. Yeah, so I'll just help you on the last bit. So dink it a bit more, big man. Oh, yes. It's like a piece of licorice, isn't it, when you've got it? So back round again. Sorry, let's see what we get this time. So we want this to be between 100 and 100. Is that it? We're going with that then. Let's flick those legs back. Let's take it back over and see if we can flick them back. You can help him now, Spence. See if we can get these two parallel. So through we go. Hook it. So put it in the hook. It's home, Spence. Keep going through. There we go. Brilliant. Well done, Spence. Right, so we're going to flick these legs back now. You got it straight? Ready? Okay. A little bit more, a little bit more. Tiny bit more. A little bit more, go on. Way too much. Flick around. So now we've got to get these two parallel. I mean, this is the trick, isn't it? Can we get them parallel to each other? Hook it again, make sure it's straight. Look at the concentration. So one sec. Oh, you're so strong. Let's have a quick look. And a little tiny bit more. Okay, let's go and take that over to a wall. So how's it looking? Do we, so lay it flat against that wall. And let's have a quick look over the top. Yeah, looking good to me. So look from the side, put it back on there. Well, is that first time?
Yeah.
Tell your face you're happy. Well done, Spence. So hopefully you've seen a little glimpse of what we're up to today, how much fun we're having. I'd like to say the 19 years that I've been teaching, it's always a bit like this. Maybe it doesn't come across on camera enough that we have a bit of a laugh and a joke when we're in the workshop. And especially this time of year, as we're like March through to the summer, we've all slightly chilled out. But all those people behind me, are fantastic and all deserve an opportunity to work in the electrical industry. So I've had a fantastic time today. Hope you've enjoyed this video. I doubt it's been any help, but it's certainly been fun.